Anyways, it's TVB. We're here with another Skyrim video. And guys, this episode, get this. I recorded 5 Skyrim episodes last night. You know, I just got my Xbox to work in my new room for the summer. And I think my mic screwed up because part of the USB slot was dented. And the live commentary was ruined. So the next 5 episodes of Skyrim Saturdays, like this one, are not going to be live commentaries. Because I have no idea what happened. It's just like my audio messed up and now like I have no live commentary. But you know what? When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. I was like, it's a perfect time since, you know, this is the last weekend of May, you know, it's before Memorial Day. Like I was gonna make this video anyway, you know, me ranking all the May films I saw this year from worst to best. You know, like what I do every month. That's just, you know, I was planning on making this video anyway, so might as well kill 2 birds with 1 stone. So yeah. Let's rank all 4 May 2018 films from worst to best. And the worst film I saw this May was Overboard. You know, not a terrible movie by any means. Like, you know, it had its moments. Like, it was okay at best. But, like, it is the definition of, like, a disposable, like, summer comedy. And, like, there's a... apparently it's a remake of a 1987, like, film. Like, just comedy remakes. Like, I just don't see the point. Like, you know, especially because comedies, like, in the old days, like, the humor gets dated a lot. Excuse me. But, I mean, I don't know. Overboard, like, again, definitely had some moments. Like, it did succeed make me laugh at a few parts. Like, especially when it's like a riches to rags story, and the guy who's, like, a son of a billionaire, like, gets amnesia, and, like, he hits his head on his yacht, and, like, and he has to go to a hospital, doesn't remember anything, so Anna Faris's character is just like, oh, he's my husband, he's gonna, you know, really just to help her pay for, like, her studies and for her girls and whatnot, and, like, and he has to work and be a construction worker, and just all the hijinks that go on there. Those were the best parts about the film, but, like, it's, like, this film, it goes up and down a lot of scenes, like, emotionally, and, like, it's a lot of stuff that you've just seen before, and, yeah, Overboard, again, it was okay, nothing and anything special, really. The second worst film I saw this May was Life of the Party, which is the newest Melissa McCarthy comedy. You know, she's done plenty of those recent years. And Melissa McCarthy, I mean, I like Melissa McCarthy. She's a great actress, and she's made me laugh before. And, like, this film, I can give us a passable rating, and I'm sorry if you guys keep hearing this squeaky chair that I'm sitting in right now. Yeah, it's creaky as all hell, but, like, anyway, Melissa McCarthy, yeah, she, like, this film did, again, it succeeded in making me laugh more than Overboard did, which is, like, the only reason why I can give it a passable rating. Like, you gotta wonder, like, you know, she's, the premise is pretty, like, you know, it works for, like, a comedy, you know, mom, like, gets divorced, and she decides to go back to college to finish her studies, and, you know, she does archaeology, and, like, she gets it on, like, oh, Melissa McCarthy's a cougar, like, oh, does funny things with his college guy, like, you know, funny things like that. I mean, again, it's another disposal summer comedy. It's the same stuff you've seen before. I know a lot of people were not a fan of this film or Overboard, but honestly, I enjoyed it. Again, I can give it a passable rating. You know, not a fan. It's not a masterpiece by any means, and, like, it definitely has its problems. Like, some scenes just go nowhere, and sometimes the characters were annoying, and, like, it's definitely not a film that I see myself remembering for a while, but, like, oh no, like, you know, for the first film that I saw, like, after moving out of the dorm I was staying all year to start off in my summer dorm, like, this was a good start because, you know, I just moved all my stuff. I just left behind, like, that, my tower dorm that I was living in all year, which honestly became more of a home to me than my actual home in New Jersey. So I was just like, you know, I'm, like, just give me a comedy. I just need to laugh at something. And if I succeed in laughing at Melissa McCarthy, like, you know, yelling at her parents about, you know, getting the divorce, and her dad's all like, oh, I'm gonna, like, Dave did this, not me, Dave is doing this, like, oh, that was funny. And yeah, I think this film did its job. Anyway, now the second best film that I saw this May was Solo, the Star Wars story. I was honestly really excited, like, really, really excited when I found Han Solo's getting his own origin story, like, a film all about him, which is, like, because he's one of the greatest characters in cinema history. I was just, like, I had so many questions, like, you know, where did he come from, like, how did he meet Chewbacca, how did he get the Millennium Falcon, where did he become such, like, a charismatic, like, swashbuckler, if you will, and, yeah, this film answers a lot of those questions fantastically. And yeah, it's great fan service, and like Chewbacca was, of course, Chewbacca is another one of my favorite Star Wars characters. Like, he was great as well. Emilia Clarke was great as Kira. I thought Woody Harrelson was great in this film. The performances, all in all, were just solid. I can sort of understand the divided like reviews. You know, it got like mixed reviews from the critics and whatnot. Like, I can understand that because this film isn't as like narratively intriguing as previous Star Wars films. But, like, the action scenes were definitely entertaining, and the film looks fantastic. Like, Ron Howard, I know, like, everyone was worried about him, like, taking the director's chair because the first two guys had, like, they were fired due to creative differences. But I thought Ron Howard did the really best that he could, and I was very happy with... I mean, I was very happy that this film turned out. And, yeah, again, great fan service. Like, I cannot wait for the finale for the new Star Wars trilogy that's coming out in 2019, whatever that's going to be, like... Because Last Jedi was my pick for best movie 2017. And I'm not entirely sure if Solo's better than Rogue One. Maybe it is, maybe it is. I'm still like debating on about that. And Force Awakens, of course, was fantastic. Like, really kick-started, you know, revived the Star Wars franchise. But yeah, Solo, like, I was really stoked for it, and it didn't disappoint me. But it didn't satisfy me. It did not satisfy me as much as my number one choice for Best Film of May. And the Best Film of May is Deadpool 2. Ah, Deadpool 2. This film was it was a very refreshing follow-up to the 2016 masterpiece that is Deadpool 1. And Deadpool 2, while I can't say that it's... I don't think it's better than Deadpool 1. Like, I think, you know, sequels, like, it's hard for me. Like, for me to think of a Deadpool film that, like, tops the same height as the first film did. But just, like, again... It took the Deadpool, like, you know, character in a different direction. And, like, you know, the mark of the mouth. He's there with all the jokes, all the fourth wall breaks, all the one-liners, like, all the funny interactions he has with, like, Colossus and Domino and Cable. Oh, Cable. Josh Brolin playing Cable. Oh, boy. Josh Brolin, he's going places, this guy. Like, you know, playing both Thanos and Cable, like, in a span of, not even, like, a span of 1 month. Like, he can pull that off. Like, that's amazing right there. The action scenes are great. I thought the... Fire Fist kid was funny as well, and yeah, just like all the stabs that they make at other superhero films, and Pinder the taxi driver was hilarious as well. Like, this film again was one of my most anticipated films of 2018, and didn't disappoint me either. So yeah, June is gonna be a good month. I know it already. Like, Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, it's like my second most anticipated movie of 2018. It's coming soon, guys. I cannot wait. And I also have to give a very special birthday shout-out to Danny. Today, May 25th, is Danny's birthday. He might have seen a lot of my other videos. He turns 19 today. That's insane. Like, we're all growing up so fast. And yeah, I wish, like, he sent me this funny video, like, back in March when he and Shane were at a Judas Priest concert. And he's just like, fuck you, Donald Trump! And then all the concert just randomly. Well, yeah, unfortunately, I couldn't play it because my phone is weird and I can't, like, you know, email it to myself, for the video to myself for whatever reason, which kind of blows. But, you know, it is what it is. But, yeah, happy birthday, Danny. Thank you so much for all the support that you've given me over the years and being in my videos. And, again, I don't plan on going home this summer, but, like, whenever I do go home, like, I God knows when that's gonna be. Like, it's gonna be a great time, like, you know, seeing everyone again. So, yeah, thanks a lot for watching, guys. Let me know, do you guys agree, disagree? Like, what films this May did I miss? I'm pretty sure I missed a few films this May. Well, you know, it was a great month of growth. So, like, you know, May 2017 was crazy for me. May 2018 was pretty crazy for me. May is just an overall, like, really great month, honestly. So, yeah, here's to a better June, and I hope you guys have a wonderful night.